So I have a friend of mine. Her husband is a stay-at-home daddy, and she's the working woman. Now, every time I present this scenario to people, they laugh. They will go mad. What do you mean the guy stays home to look after the baby and the chick works? I'm like, that's how it is. That's how it is. So I keep on asking ladies, is this the kind of scenario? Is this the kind of situation you would consider in your relationship?
I think I wouldn't mind that, working and then he's at home. As long as at the end of the day you have just that memorandum of understanding that, yes, I am the one working at the moment. Maybe later you will get a job. Some circumstances lead to the man staying at home. So I think I have no problem with that. Unless the man has a problem with that. Now there will have serious issues.
So he doesn't work. He doesn't have a job. No, he doesn't bring in any income. Yeah, he doesn't bring in an income. He has no job. Literally, you're taking care of him. You buy his underwear. You buy him food. You fuel his car. You bolt the car. But then he expects you to get a maid. Because, boss, if that was the circumstance, you don't have a job, but she has a job, she takes care of you, and she says, you know what? Instead of getting a maid, why don't you stay home and look after the baby? Is that something you would do?
I can agree, because at a certain scenarios, there are some circumstances we can't deny. You get, there was a man, he had these boda riders. He had married his wife, put her home. Then, unexpectedly, in the morning, he had to go for work as usual. Reaching there, he had not even reached the stage. He got an accident. The car cut off the legs. He had no limbs. They called the lady home. Hey, your man is here, got an accident. Tuliwa no mudwaliro, Chirudu Hospital. The woman had to rush there. The woman was working in the market. The woman had to rush there to check on the man. Reaching there, she was like, oh my God, my world is ending. Now he has been providing with this and that. Now I think everything is done. But she never gave up on the man. She carried the man after the time they had spent to the hospital, took him home. She started take care of the man. As a junior, as a zicharimu, ngamba mangwe, nasimani, as a MB. Then she had to provide for the man. And the man had no limbs to work because she had admitted that he's my man. We've been together for a long time. I have a job. Why should I give up on my man? You get. That's how it is. Newano. Nebofuna kakunyonyo gira no sigale waka. Chitegera. Umkaza jaku yomba. Chisigala waka. He stays home. He doesn't work. Teguagala kola. Yet you have problems there. You get. You have to be understanding. We face problems in different ways at work. You get. Today I have a job. Tomorrow it's not there. Yet you're working. You have to provide. You get.
So if you're looking for money in a relationship, if you're looking for a man who is going to provide, like you said, there's a job today, there's no job tomorrow. When you start dating this man, he's got a good job, he's a manager somewhere, he gets his good money, he takes care of you. And then 3-4 months down the road, things happen in this country. You don't know. Someone just comes and scoops the job, he's laid off, there's no money anymore, and yeah. It gets ugly. Now, the problem with men is that because oba of ego, oba chichi, when he has no job,
frustration makes him quarrel about everything. Now, that's where you start having issues. Mm-hmm. You're the one working, taking care of everything. You're also frustrated because everything is on you.
Yes.
But then there's also a man at home who is being nagging and everything. And that's where everything starts going bad.
Yes.
Yeah.
So some of them naturally don't want to work. There are boys in this city that I know who don't love to work. They are always looking out for a woman. Aina kasente. Eh? You know somebody? Do you know a guy who doesn't work? Eh? You know someone who just is looking out for a man who has money?
Exactly. Yeah, those types of men. Oh, God.
You know somebody? You know a guy?
Yes, they're there. I've seen one.
Have you dated one? By the way, so a guy let me tell you, there are men in this city that I know. I can even name ngamuba manyi basalebu bamwe ngatibayi ntibayimbi obaba actor omanyi those people were famous for being famous. Yeah? They're just there. They're, everyone knows them. They have good bodies. They dress good. They smell good. But they don't work. They drive fancy cars because, Bambi, there's Mukuba Cheyos out there who are looking for men. So they keep sending cars. But these guys, Basuda Mu, mu kitchens, they sleep in people's kitchens. And then he has someone's daughter out there. He's also confusing. Mbuya. That's the kind of man. Oh, but he looks good. You know this scenario? What's his name? Gareth and the princess. Have you read about it? Yeah. Gareth Onyango and the princess? You've read about the story. The Kampala Sun said she took him to Dubai for a birthday, for her birthday, and all that Gareth could contribute was whiskey. Yes, Gareth Nice Matwaya, by the way. He's one of those guys. They can tell you stories. I don't want to dig deep into them, but yeah, when you meet him, this girl is crazy. She's mad over Gareth. Can you imagine Gareth Onyango, who has no job? Does Gareth have a job? Have you ever heard anyone saying Gareth does this? No, he manages clubs, bars. He does, I don't know the last time he had a gig. Yeah?
Something like that, promotions of bars and everything.
Okay, yeah. So where I'm going with this conversation is very simple. If you have more money than he does, if you have money to take care of the home, if you feel like, even if I had kids tomorrow, I will take care of my children, would you then be the one to finance a wedding? Because this chick says she wants to marry him. She badly, badly wants him to propose. In fact, I hear they had a lot of trouble in Dubai because she asked him to propose. Gareth Nagamba need the boss. I'm not going to commit to this anytime soon. I'm asking, would you get desperate to the point that you would finance your own wedding?
No. No, now that's a different story. Because when I've had a man who has taken care of me and at the end of the day maybe had an accident or was sacked from the job for some reason I may not understand, that's a different story. Yeah. Now, when I have someone who I'm dating, he's not contributing anything.
But whiskey.
Only whiskey, mm-hmm. Like you said. He's not contributing anything. Now he also expects me to contribute for the wedding. Generally, every expense is on me from day one. That's another story. I can't agree to that. Because I'm going to give birth to the children. I'll be the man and everything in the relationship. Don't you think so?
Yeah. Would you pay?
No, I wouldn't.
Would you pay for your own wedding?
I can't.
If you love him badly, if you really, really love him, and the only thing that's standing between you and marrying this man is the fact that he doesn't have money, would you?
No, I can't. That is totally taking advantage of me just because I love
and
you.
You also want.
You're not taking advantage. You're exploiting me. Exactly.
But what's wrong with it? What's wrong with it? He's your husband. He's going to be your man. You have the money he doesn't have. You guys have been talking about getting married. For some reason, there's no money for him to contribute to this wedding. But you have all the money and much more. What's wrong with it?
For me, I don't support men like that. Because tomorrow you're going to give birth to the kids. The kids, they are going to be asking, Dad, I want ice cream. You'll be like, go to mommy. What if mommy is not there? Then you don't provide ice cream to your kid? I don't support that.
There is no bread at home. Bread.
You guys don't understand this thing. You can provide everything. You even give him upkeep. As in, that umbrella is a wallet. Was it jam wallet to you? You know how we go to visit men and then they get their wallets? Nabala Satunaga Kua? You do that for your husband. The women who do that for their men. When she's leaving in the morning, she says, oh, you're going to cut your hair? You're going to do a haircut? Okay, so this is 20K for your haircut. This is 50K for your fuel. You're going to have lunch. I'm sure you will have lunch. This is 20K for your lunch. As in 200,000, Nazimuan is ngaweba tuwana fe. You're going to do your hair. Oh, you're going to do hair. Your hair is 200,000. He counts 200,000. He gives it to you. Oh, you're going to do this. Yeah, you're going to see your mom. Oh, please buy for her something. Nakuweza shopping. So they do the same thing. And she's going to do that for you. But the only thing that's standing between you. Because women don't want to hear someone saying, oh, oyo, gola boyo, ebiembaga byonna, ebibobyo, nabulichari mubibob, yulichimuchinu, ne mocho kachibatu alewawe. Even the sofas they bought for her father, she bought. It's like an abomination. It's like something so ugly. Why would it be in this 2018, why wouldn't a woman sponsor her own wedding?
I have been sponsoring everything, like you've said. Before the wedding, we go out, I buy the drinks. You go to the salon, oh, baby, I want some... I have some money for the salon, I take you there. But now it's the wedding. It's like having my birthday, and then you come and tell me happy birthday, and then now I have to finance everything on the birthday, and then I invite you and be like, oh, he is the one who has done everything here. You see, that's the same scenario at the end of the day. I just need one day to be mine. Yes, just give me one day, that wedding day. And then everyone is like, anange, umwana ya wasomsa, they both have money. You see, at the end of the day, you look like a very successful couple. Not that that's my goal, but I also would like to be surprised once in a while. Because dishing out money all the time, it's going to be one-sided. The relationship is going to be one-sided. I don't want to be a part of that.
Guys, in 2018, I keep on saying, I don't think there's a problem. Culturally, yes. Even if you talk to your fellow women, they'll tell you, no way. At least just be there. Find him a job. Let him at least contribute 50%. But in this day and age, if you're a woman and you were able to finance a wedding, why not go ahead and marry your man? Because somebody else is going to come, finance the wedding, and take him away from you. And because you were scared, bagena kuogera ombo obli chimunze ya chugula nze ya chugula bo chugula, then what? Bono chugula ya nafuno lubuto panangi. There's some things that are not going to... They should not, exactly, they're not going to kill. There should not be an issue in this day and age. Yes, when your mother was getting married, the man was required to pay. But this is 2018. We all work. We are emancipated. We want equal rights with our men. So, if you want equal rights, go ahead and finance your bloody wedding. And see what to ofumbe you. Guys, thank you so much for being a part of the show. It was a hot discussion. If you have anything to contribute to this one, please go ahead and use the hashtag Salon Talk. My name is Mary Luswata. I had this one with beautiful women and a gentleman. We look forward to seeing you on the runway. Take care of yourselves. Don't forget to come to Spectra Salon and Spa. We're in Kabalagala today, but you can pass by Bugolovi as well. And there's another one in Makindye. Bye-bye.